Samsung's been launching a bunch of phones now, and today we've got the latest from the A series, the Galaxy A30 and the A50. In today's video, let's unbox them and take a close look. Hey guys, Ash here from C4 eTech, and let's get started. If you do end up liking this video, please don't forget to turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon. Now, given these two share quite a bit in common, I decided to save you guys some time and unbox them together in the same video. Good idea? Or would you want to see dedicated unboxing videos? Here's a poll, let me know. Okay, onto the A30 and A50. Opening up the boxes, we've got another box inside. Here we find the regular leaflets and a soft case. Next, we get to the phones themselves. Removing the plastic off, the backs look great. The rainbow-esque effect on the A50. Now, does that remind you of the Vivo Nex? Or am I the only one who feels that way? Let me know in the comments. Turning them on and putting the cases on them, the design still does shine through. So what else do we have in the box? A pair of regular earphones, not in-ear. Then there's a USB Type-C cable and a 15-watt charger. Oh, almost forgot, there's also a SIM tool on the inside. And now let's get to these phones. Let's start with the similarities. Both are made out of plastic, but they have nice attractive backs. The A50 has, like I said, a Vivo Nex style rainbow effect that's quite prominent. Now the refraction effects are more subtle on the A30, but they still exist. Both these phones are IP68 water and dust resistant. Both have Type-C ports, which is welcome. There are no Bixby buttons. There is a dedicated microSD slot. And oh yeah, the headphone jack is also retained. As for the display, we have the same 6.4-inch 19.5x9 Infinity U panel. Now that's Samsung's peak for an AMOLED panel with a teardrop notch. The display seems great, as most Samsung AMOLEDs are in fact great. The resolution is a very respectable Full HD Plus, so the pixel density is over 400 pixels per inch. So that means everything is sharp, the colors as expected are punchy, both phones have support for always-on displays. Other similarities here include the software. They're both on Android Pie with One UI on top, so they feel fast and snappy, the A50 a little more so. Sadly, Samsung has disabled haptic feedback on both phones, and the Pro Mode, well, it's the depreciated one. I mean, I don't understand why Samsung still does this. It's disappointing, especially when the phones hold so much promise. Anyway, since we mentioned cameras, let's talk about them. The Galaxy A30 sports two cameras to the back, a 16 megapixel primary with the f1.7 lens, along with a 5 megapixel ultra wide. The images seem good. There is a little color difference between the regular and wide shots, but for the most part, the A30 seems to do well. The selfie camera is a 16 megapixel shooter, and as you can see, it performed quite well too. There is a portrait mode as well over here. The A50, on the other hand, has a triple camera setup. A 25 megapixel primary with a f1.7 lens, a 5 megapixel depth sensor, and an 8 megapixel ultra wide. There is again some color difference between the two sensors, but the primary has good color reproduction, good details. The wide angle one, it seems okay, but overall it does add a new perspective and the cameras seem quite interesting. The selfie camera is a 25 megapixel here, it's an f2 aperture lens. Do know that the A30 and the A50, for both the selfie and wide angle cameras, they come with fixed focus, which is a bit of a letdown. Now the next difference is with regards to the chip underneath. The A30 sports the same Exynos 7904 chip as the Galaxy M20. Now that's quite a good performer, as we've seen in the past, while the A50 gets a new Exynos 9610 chip. The 9610 can be seen as Samsung's premium mid-range chip, given it's built on the 10nm process, has 4 A73 cores to go along with 4 A53 cores. Both phones start with 464 RAM storage. 64GB on the base variant is quite impressive, and they both also have 4000mAh batteries. Now for the final difference, the A30 gets a fingerprint scanner to the back, and this worked quite well, faster than Samsung's other rear fingerprint scanner implementations. The Galaxy A50 though gets an in-display fingerprint scanner. This was again quite fast in my limited time with it. So overall, Samsung has two quite strong offerings here in the Galaxy A30 and the A50. I do wish Samsung would stop crippling their own cameras with limitations on the Pro Mode and capping video recording to 1080p 30fps. I mean, what is this, 2014? Anyway, all that said, if Samsung can still nail the pricing, get the A30 to around 14-15,000 rupees and the A50 to around 20,000 rupees, I think these would be solid options for anybody wanting a phone from Samsung. I mean, they're still not gonna outspec or outperform a Redmi Note 7 or a Poco F1, but they could still be quite decent offerings if Samsung manages to price them right. What do you think the A30 and the A50 should be priced at? Let me know in the comments below. And with that, we get to the end of this video. Thumbs up, thumbs down based on what you felt about it. Subscribe, turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon if you haven't yet. Thanks a lot for watching. Till next time, my name's Ash. You've been watching C4 Retech, and I'm signing off for now. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.